Hello. Today I got Dr. Vamsi Krishna Varma, a spine surgeon working in Sunshine Hospital, Hyderabad, as my guest. We will know more things about the spine and the treatment modalities available now. A lot of people have got a back pain. In fact, any orthopedic doctor's clinic, 70% of the patients come with the spine problems or back pain problems. And there are so many myths and so many apprehensions and so many misplaced ideas about the back pain and its treatment. So today we will try to clear them as many as possible. Vamsi,
yes,
welcome to the Sunshine Digital Platform.
Yes,
right, I know that you are a spine surgeon.
Yes,
just what is the commonest problem of the spine in Indian population?
So today if you see it, it is the neck pain and the back pain.
Okay.
Without any clinical or radiological evidence.
Yes.
So
what is the reason for this? Is it the software?
Reason, it's the lifestyle, sir. Lifestyle. Sitting is the new disease, the new smoking, that's what they call today.
Okay.
Because it's the software and the telephones
are
responsible for the neck and the back pain.
Right. Let us say there plenty of our friends are there, software people looking at this program.
Yes, sir.
Tell in brief 5 points what they should do, they should not do.
Yes, sir. There's something called as ergonomics, which everywhere, every software company tries to teach them very often, but most of the times we don't follow. But the thing is, you have to cut down on usage of your phones. It has to be in front of your face than trying to bend forward, because every 5 degrees you bend, there is 50 kilos adding to your neck, because the head is heavy and the neck is pretty small. So it is hanging on your neck, that's where you have the problem.
So you have to look at the phone like this.
Yes, sir. You have to look at it like this and see that.
Yeah.
So, and number two.
Sitting posture.
Sitting posture, you should be upright. You should have a support on your back whenever you're using your computer. Your shoulder should be taut. You should not be hanging forward or drooping forward. Yes. So that is the reason why.
That is number two.
Number two.
Mm.
Number three is you should know where to keep your keyboard, your mouse, and your distance of your monitor from where you're sitting. Yes, number three. And number four is try to get up every 45 minutes. Try to place a bottle of water somewhere far away from your desk. Go there, have a sip of water and get back to your seat. It will help a lot in decreasing your back and the neck pains.
So basically posture is very important.
Posture.
You should not bend the neck.
Yes.
You should have a pillow in the back and
yes,
all that stuff.
Yes.
These are all very important points, especially for software people.
Yes, sir.
A lot of women, the housewives,
yes,
come with a back pain and a terrible shoulder pains and all that stuff.
Yes,
so what is the problem?
So the main reason for them is lack of exercise, because India is a country where women work hard, but they don't work hard for themselves. They only work for the family. So that's where they neglect themselves. They don't think that they have to take care of themselves. But I tell them that they have to be selfish to themselves. They have to work for themselves. At least 10 minutes of walk a day will cut down on all these pains.
Bro, when do you need an MR scan for a patient who comes to your clinic? A lot of patients keep on abusing us, whether rightly or wrongly, that every time you go to a doctor, they will ask for MR scan and all this stuff. So when do you ask an MR scan for a back pain patient?
So today I get two kinds of patients where I don't ask a scan and they demand me to do a scan, and then I ask a scan and they demand me why you need a scan. Yeah.
It's no win situation.
No win situation, sir. So what I normally do is, for me, spine surgery is mathematics. 1 + 1 = 2. If my clinical examination, if the patient has the symptom, I'm sure that the patient has some kind of a disc prolapse or some kind of a lumbar canal stenosis, that's when the MRI is needed. So I can substantiate and I can tell the patient that you have this problem and this is when you need an MRI. Not every patient needs an MRI in spine surgery.
Right. Now coming to the common disc problem.
Yes, sir.
So what is a disc bulge and disc prolapse? How does that affect, and when do you need the operation?
So surgery, if you ask me, it is the last option. It is only less than 1% of the people out of 100 patients who come to me with the disc problems. Disc bulges are very common today.
So, let me stop you there. I think you appreciated that less than 1% needs surgery. That means every 100 patients he sees in the clinic, only one patient needs operation. Many patients and many people feel that doctors do unnecessary surgeries, but it's an unfortunate misconception. No doctor does unnecessary surgery. And especially spine, there should be strict indications, and we will know what are those indications.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So if you take a disc problem, somebody has a disc prolapse, and this common term, they say they have this sciatica, the leg pain. That's in layman's term, which is used regularly, or in pinched nerve. Even these patients, most of the times, it's the medicines which will take care of the pain. But some people come with an excruciating pain, not able to walk in spite of medicines for a week or 10 days or 2 weeks time. And then they develop weakness in their foot or in their toes or in their legs, which is very evident, where either the slipper slips out of their foot or they're not able to walk distances. These are the patients where definitely they are the patients which are indicated for surgery, and they will get back to their normal life.
Yeah, in the olden days, people again still a lot of apprehensions that once you get the spine surgery, number one, your legs may get paralyzed, and number two, you are not fit for family life.
Yes, sir.
So very, very unfortunate misconceptions.
Yes, sir.
What is the truth?
Sir, spine surgery is a myth. That's what everybody thinks. It's not, because today spine surgery is advanced. We are at par with anybody in the world, in India today, and in Hyderabad and in Sunshine. And the myth about somebody have becoming a paraplegic, quadriplegic, not able to pass the urine and motion, it's extremely rare in the lower levels of L4-5 and L5 disc prolapse, because 90% of the disc prolapse happen at L4-5 and L5-S1. Even if you get operated at these levels, it is difficult for me to make you paraplegic or a quadriplegic, or difficult to make you in passing urine and urine motion. So that's a myth.
So in other words, I'll tell you, the spine surgery, you becoming paraplegic or paralyzed in the legs, is 1 in 1 lakh chance?
1 in 1,000 cases, 1,000 surgeries, okay, sir, or okay. More than that.
And what about this not fit for family life? Many young men have got this brain block. They are not fit for any sexual life.
No, it doesn't happen in a spine surgery who has a disc that thinking that it's all in the mind. It's not from because of the spine surgeon or because of the spine pathology.
So spine surgery has got no relevance in sexual actions. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So extreme 1 in lakh population, yes. Sometimes it can happen,
it can happen,
it is not the regular thing.
Extremely.
So right, that's right. Now, what is the standard treatment for a disc prolapse nowadays? Surgical.
So surgically, what we do it's only a significant disc, only on one side, and only left leg or a right leg pain. We call something called as microdiscectomy.
Yeah, what is the difference between the olden days discectomy and microdiscectomy?
So olden days discectomy is we don't have these kind of microscopes or loops which are available. So people used to be longer exposures. They have to knock off the lot of anatomy to approach the disc and take off the disc.
So can you show in this spine?
Today what we do is we just do a small incision, okay, and we just take a small of an tissues which are there with the small bit of a bone. We reach there and we just remove the disc. And most of my patients today, they come in the morning, they get the surgery done and go back in the evening.
Yeah, in other words, in the olden days, the discectomy means you make a big cut and then take off all these bones and then go to the spinal cord, which is a lot of morbidity and lot of pain to the patients. And sometimes the spinal cord is also damaged with the nerve roots. But nowadays, it's a microdiscectomy is basically you cut very small. Not only that, you also use a microscope where the nerves are seen bigger. So the level or the element of damage, chance of damage is minuscule, hardly not there at all. Am I right?
Yes, you're absolutely
okay,
right.
Now coming to the second part of the problems, I have seen many patients coming with a listhesis or bone slipping on the bone.
Yes, sir.
You keep saying that spinal fixations.
Yes, sir.
Now tell me about that.
So listhesis is a thing where the spine is slipping over the one vertebrae. So because of this, what happens is there is a lot of pressure on the spinal cord, because there is a specific diameter in the canal which has to be there for the spinal cord to pass through whenever it is going forward. So that's when they decreases the size of the canal. That's when people will have this problem of difficulty in walking, paresthesias in the legs and all these things. So these are the patients mostly we see in the woman more than 50 years of age in India or all over the world. Men is pretty less, especially the degenerative listhesis. So what we do in this patient is we get back the slip which is going forward and fix it with the screws like what we see the screws here. On either side we put the screws and then we fix it so that it doesn't move forward and patient get back to its normal anatomy.
Right. Now let me take you to the third problem, however rare it is now. We see some of the children coming with a, what do you call, scoliosis or humpback.
Yes,
so what is the etiology and what is the treatment in brief?
Sir, in scoliosis there are, in children that's what we see, mostly the younger children less than 10 years of age and the children between 10 to 18 years of age. The children less than 10 years of age, the scoliosis is because of the congenital anomalies. There is some problems with the bone formation or differentiation. So that's when these patients, what happens is they develop scoliosis at the age of 5 or less than 5. And these patients, if we don't address them at a younger age, they will lead to a bigger deformities. Whereas the children, when we see a scoliosis, most of the times recognized by the parents or their school friends because they are bullied because of the kind of shapes what they have in the school. So these are the curves where which happens after 11 years, and we don't have any specific reasons why this type of scoliosis happens. And again, these scoliosis, it all depends upon how much degree of the curve it is, because the curve increases during their menstrual cycle, starting of the menstrual cycle for the next 2 years. So these are the times we depend upon the size of the curve, which is more than 40 degrees. That's when we correct the curve and fix it with pedicle screws.
Finally, a lot of young children, school-going children, have got a big school bags, and most of them walk like this.
Yes, sir.
What is your advice to the parents and the children?
Sir, already the government of Telangana has come up with an specific guidelines to the schools that from 5th standard to 10th standard, the weight of the bags cannot be more than these things. So it has to be followed by every school, because there are lot of things are observed and lot of literature support telling that the children are complaining of the back pains because of the heavy bags and the kind of things what they're carrying every day to the school. I think they should come down on that. They have to follow the guidelines according to the government of Telangana.
Right, good. So friends, Dr. Vamsi has given a very beautiful clarity of the spine and spine surgeries. And a majority of the people, you don't need operation. Let me tell you, the back pain is treatable, preventable, proper posture, exercises, and a bit of lifestyle modification, it's all that you need. But if you got any problems with the spine, don't hesitate to come to Sunshine Hospitals, both in Secunderabad and Gachibowli branches, and ask for Dr. Vamsi Krishna Varma, who is going to get you back on your feet with your erect posture. Have a great day.